Hi, I'm Ann Hakey. I'm a professor in the College of Computing and Information Sciences in the PhD department, and I'm in the Multidisciplinary Vision Research Labs. Content-based image retrieval is a method of using information in the image itself. Information such as color, contrast, edges, those types of features for storing and retrieving images. And it's a potential solution to the problem of ever-increasing amounts of digital images and the fact that most of these images are not annotated. That is, there hasn't been somebody to add labels or tags to those images. And in the biomedical area, one of the major uses is to be able to retrieve similar images, okay, for teaching, for research, for diagnosis. Our current dermatology project is to extend the traditional content-based image retrieval to what we're calling human-centered CBIR. And we're using a couple of different techniques to try to elicit domain knowledge from our expert dermatologists. We're doing eye tracking and also having them do verbal annotations as they're describing these images so that we can understand their perceptual expertise as well as their conceptual knowledge. The intent is to model the data and to somehow bring all those multimodal types of data together to better organize the images in new types of databases.
We're in the Image Eye Tracking Lab in the MVRL, and this is the setup that we used for the human-centered CBIR in some of our experiments. In the setup, the physician, the dermatologist, was seated in front of the eye tracking system. The eye tracker is below the display that the physician looked at. Seated next to the physician was the physician's assistant, who was listening to what the physician is describing as she provides the differential diagnosis, and the student was operating the eye tracking system. And so the physician would look at the image and develop the differential diagnosis.
We're looking at the dorsal hand of an African-American woman. She has multiple hyperkeratotic,
hyperpigmented papules on her hand and also a large plaque, maybe a coalescence of multiple papules.
By providing explorable interfaces through natural interaction and having databases that are organized according to expert knowledge, it's our hope that doctors will be able to find images that are more relevant to their needs. Again, similar images for teaching, variations, images that resemble those of their patients. Our research project can serve as a model for RIT's push towards more multidisciplinary research, and also RIT's commitment towards experiential learning for students.